Very good morning to another present here. I am Assistant Professor Kiran Anand from Department of Management. Today we'll be discussing a subject called Financial Accounting. Under that subject, we'll be discussing third chapter. And the chapter name is Royalty Account. So before we start solving the problem related to this chapter, we need to first understand what is royalty account. To substantiate the meaning of this royalty account, let us take an example. There are two persons Mr. A and Mr. B, where Mr. B is an unemployed and he doesn't have any financial investment to start any business. So Mr. A is an employed in good company and he owns a plot of land. So Mr. A and Mr. B, both are friends. Mr. B someday just come and he approaches Mr. A and he requests him to give his land so that Mr. B, as he is unemployed, he can start mining. So Mr. A, he tells, he is ready to give the land, but on a basis that he has to pay some amount for utilizing the right of using that land. So from this, what we need to understand is the amount what Mr. B he pays to Mr. A for using the right of land, it is called as what? Royalty. So in the same way, let us take another example. Mr. A is an author, he writes a book and he doesn't have any kind of idea about publishing the book. So he approaches Mr. B, he is a publisher, and Mr. B agrees to publish the book which has been written by Mr. A. So that publishing, he is going to take some amount from Mr. A. The amount which has been given by Mr. A to Mr. B for publishing the book which has been written by Mr. A is the author. It is called as what? Royalty. It is called as copyright royalty. Let us take another example. Mr. B is a manufacturer and Mr. A, he wants to manufacture the same product what has been manufactured by Mr. B. So Mr. A, he approaches Mr. B and he requests him to give the right to manufacture the product, and for that he is ready to pay some amount. The amount which has been paid by Mr. B to Mr. A for manufacturing the goods which has been manufactured by Mr. B, it is called as what? Royalty. That is another type of royalty, which is something called as patent royalty. I think from this you have understood what is the concept of royalty. When it comes to accounting for royalty, we need to prepare journal entries and we need to prepare ledger account. Before we start preparing the journal entries and ledger account, we need to prepare a royalty analysis table, something called as what? Royalty. So this royalty analysis table, it is going to give the values which is required to pass the journal entries and to prepare the ledger account. Before we start preparing this royalty analysis table, we need to understand a certain terminology. Only when we understand the terminology related to a royalty account, it is possible for us to prepare a royalty analysis table. Only if we are able to prepare the royalty analysis table, it is possible for us to pass the journal entry and to prepare the ledger accounts. So let us understand the various terminology which is related to royalties. So let us take this example itself, Mr. A and Mr. B. In our previous example, I told Mr. B is going to approach Mr. A for taking the right of the land for mining purpose. So here, Mr. A will be called as lessor, and Mr. B will be called as lessee. So who is a lessor? A lessor is a person who gives a rights to the other person. So that person will be termed as what? Lessor. And the person who takes the right from the person is called as what? Lessee. So these are the two terminology what we need to understand, lessor and lessee. So one fine day, say for example, the lease has been taken by Mr. B from Mr. A for 5 years. One fine day, Mr. B, he approaches Mr. A and he tells that he is not able to pay the amount because of strike or because of some issues. So Mr. A definitely is not going to agree, because for example, if you are being a owner of a property or if you are a owner of a house, in case if a tenant, if he tells that he is not able to pay the rent because of some issues, definitely you are not going to agree. In the same way, though Mr. A and Mr. B are friends, Mr. B, if he is going to request him to, what is it, allow him not to pay the amount or the royalty value because of strike or any issues, definitely Mr. A is not going to agree, because Mr. A, he knows that business is different from what is something called as what? Friendship. So Mr. A, he comes to a conclusion, so to avoid these issues to proceed further. So he tells, see, whatever the kind of production you do, let me fix a slab rate. Okay. And what value of production, it doesn't matter. Every month or every year, however we are going to agree, though on those month or on those years, what you have to do, you have to pay me a certain minimum amount. So that minimum amount, what has been agreed between Mr. A and Mr. B, it is called as minimum rent. So from this, what we need to understand, whenever Mr. B, if he is not able to extract or if he is not able to produce the value of the goods which is required to sell and to pay to Mr. A. So from this, what we need to understand, whenever your production, it drops below the decided level, then you have to pay something called as what? Minimum rent. So whenever you are able to achieve the production level, then you have to pay something called as royalty. So these are the two terminology what we need to understand. One is minimum rent, one is royalty. Then coming to the other two terminology, which is something called as short working. And surplus. So what is the meaning of short working? So when you are not able to produce up to this slab rate, what has been fixed by Mr. A, that is the lesser, that amount, it is called as what? Short workings. So when you are able to produce more than the required level, what has been fixed by the lesser, that is more than the minimum rent, then that value, it is called as what? Surplus. So now we have understood the various terminology. We understood who is a lesser, and we understood who is a lessee. We understood what is minimum rent. We understood what is short working, and we also understood what is royalty, and we understood what is surplus. Then we have to understand something called as a recoupment of short working. So what do you mean by recoupment of short working? Let us take an example. There is a lease agreement between Mr. A and Mr. B for 5 years. First year, Mr. B, he pays royalty. Second year, again he pays royalty. Third year, his production, it drops less than minimum rent. So he has to pay minimum rent. So when it drops less than minimum rent, as we discussed, it is called as what? Short working. So short working in simple terms, it can be said as something what the shortage, what the lessee has to pay to the lesser. To when to recover this, what is a short working? Again, Mr. B, when there is a short working, he approaches Mr. A and he requests him, see, whatever the production what I did, entire amount I have paid, though there is a short working. So give me some option so that I can refund this amount in future. So Mr. A, he tells to Mr. B, that there are three methods or three options what I'll be giving to you. In under the three options, any one option you can select and you can repay the short working whenever there is a surplus. So whenever there is a surplus, for example, in case if next year if there is a surplus, so out of this surplus, this shortage amount it can be recovered. That is what the agreement has been done between Mr. A and Mr. B. So this arrangement, it is called as what? Recoupment of short working. The year in which you have a short working, you are going to see whether there is a surplus in future year, and out of that surplus, if you are going to recover that amount of the short working, then it is called as what? Recoupment of short working. When it comes to recoupment of short working, there are three methods of recoupment of short working. One is fixed recoupment, floating recoupment, another one is lifetime recoupment. Now let us understand one by one. I think you have understood the meaning of recoupment. What is recoupment? Whenever there is a surplus, when you are going to recover the, there is a short working, that is called as what? Short working recoupment. Under a short working recoupment, there are three methods, which are those: fixed recoupment, floating, and lifetime recoupment. Then what is fixed recoupment? For example, when we have a lease agreement done for 5 years, and in the problem, if it is given, the short working can be recovered up to first 3 years, which means up to first 3 years, whenever or whichever the year in which there is a short working, you can recover that short working when you have a surplus within this 3 years itself. In case if you have a surplus after 3 years, that cannot be recovered. But because in the problem it has been clearly mentioned, whatever the short working it is there, it can be recouped within the first 3 years itself. This type of recoupment of short working, it is called as what? Fixed recoupment. There is one more method of recoupment, which is something called as floating recoupment. What is this floating recoupment? Under floating recoupment, what happens? You have to see in which year there is a short working. And in the problem, it will be mentioned in how many years you can recover the short working. So in case in the problem, if it tells that the short working can be recovered in subsequent 2 years, or if it tells that the short working can be recovered in following 2 years, from the year in which you have a short working, from that year you have to see how many years what it has been mentioned in the problem. For example, if in the problem they have told you can recover the short working in subsequent 2 years, and if you have a short working in second year, this short working can be recovered from the surplus of third year or from fourth year, which is nothing but the following years. How many years it has been mentioned in the problem? Those many years, the following years you are going to see, ignoring the year in which you got the short working. Such type of recoupment, it is called as what? Floating recoupment. Now we understood what is fixed and floating recoupment. Now let us see what is lifetime recoupment. Lifetime recoupment, it doesn't matter in which year you get a short working. Any year short working can be recovered in any year's surplus. There is no time limit. There is no kind of, what is that, fixed year in which you have to recover the short working. For example, you get a short working in first year and there is a surplus in fifth year. Yes, you can recover the, what is a short working in fifth year also, which means there is no time limit for recovering the short working. Any year's short working can be recovered from any year's surplus. So these are the methods of recoupment of short working. I think now it is clear. Now let us see what are the templates should be used for preparing the royalty analysis table. Now understanding these concepts or the terminology, now it will be easy for us to know how the royalty analysis table need to be prepared. And after getting the value from the royalty analysis table, let us move on how, in understanding how we have to pass the journal entries and how the ledger account has to be prepared. Preparing ledger account and the journal entries, it is different part. First let us see how the royalty analysis table will be. So when it comes to preparing royalty analysis table, columns we need to prepare. Let us understand one by one which are those columns, how it has to be prepared. The first column for preparing royalty analysis table is you have to take years. How many years information will be given? It is not like how many years lease they have taken, the lesser and the lessee, all the information need to be given. It doesn't work out in that way. Lease may be taken for any number of years, but only for understanding purpose, only few number of years information will be given in the problem. So those many years you need to write it here. Whether it is for 3 years or whether it is for 4 years, 5 years, whatever the details given in the problem, those years you have to write it. So this will be the first column. And the second column is, what is the output? The output value will be given in the problem itself. For example, let us take the lease agreement is for 3 years and the output for the first year is 1000. It will be given in units. Second year is 2000 and third year is 3000. So this will be our output column. And the third column will be royalty. How much is the royalty? What the lessee has to pay to the lessor will be given in the, what is the problem? In our example, let us take Mr. B, that is the lessee, he has to pay rupees 1 as in royalty for each unit of output produced. Just for an example, right? 1 rupee. So per unit it is 1 rupees 1 rupee 1. and output is 1000, so you need to multiply this two, so you are going to get how much royalty he has to pay. So the royalty what Mr. V has to pay to Mr. V has to pay to Mr. A for the first year is 1000, for the second year is 2000, for the third year is 3000. So this will be our third column, and the fourth column is something called as minimum rent. Minimum rent will be given in the problem itself. While discussing the theoretical part, we understood what is the meaning of minimum rent. So now what you need to do for the upcoming columns, what you need to include, let us not get confused. Just you have to compare the things. How we have to compare the things? We have to compare minimum rent with royalty. Whenever your minimum rent or royalty, if it is less than minimum rent, you have to start comparing this two. The value will be given in the problem itself. Whenever your royalty, if it is less than minimum rent, then it is called as short workings. So this will be a one column. Another column is whenever your royalty, if it is more than minimum rent, then it is called as surplus. So we have to see whether this short working can be recovered or irrecovered. It is going to become what? Irrecovered. When the royalty can be recovered, or sorry, short working can be recovered, whenever there is a surplus, if you are able to, what is it, take off the shortages what you have in other years, then it is called as what? Short working recovered. When you are not able to do that, it is called short working irrecovered. So those will be the next two columns. Either this short working, it can be recovered, or the short working, it becomes irrecovered. Finally, what we need to do after doing all this, we need to see how much is the amount which is to be paid to lessor. So this is all about the what is a royalty analysis table and the template what we need to use and the nine columns what has to be included. Once this is done and once we prepare the royalty analysis table, get the value, then we'll start preparing the journal entries, then we'll start posting it to lectures.